In this session, we are going to see accessibility testing. The name itself suggests that accessibility testing is going to focus on the system accessibility. Wait a minute. So, accessibility testing is a subset of your usability testing. In usability testing, we saw that usability testing is going to focus on the real-time users. If you remember in the session, I told you the example of SPPU website where you are going to fill your examination form or aap wahan pe result dekhte ho or you are going to give your online examination. So the user for that system is real-time user, that is you all people. And you start testing the system as per your requirement or whatever task is given to you, you started doing what? Usability testing on your SPPU portal or on your system. In the same way, the accessibility testing is a subset of usability testing. This means that the user is directly involved in the accessibility testing like this. It is performed to ensure that application being tested is usable by people with disabilities like hearing, color blindness, old age, etc. But now from this you will come to know that the user for the accessibility testing will be some special users like who have some disabilities, like they cannot hear or they have the color blindness or the old age people, whatever it may be. These are some special kind of users that are going to test your system, and this kind of testing is called as your what? Accessibility testing. In this, the users are not the normal users, they are some special types of users. So what is the category of special type of user? It can be the user having some hearing problem, that is a disability with hearing, the user who have the color blindness. You might be knowing that the color blindness is one of the special feature that many human beings have, that they could not recognize the color. Ha konta color hai kiwa to konta color hai asa te olkhu nahi shakat, tyancha lakshat nahi. Or the people having the old age. So these are the users which are going to test your system on the basis of accessibility testing. The accessibility aim to cater people of different ability. So what can be the different ability? Visual impairments, physical impairments, hearing impairment, cognitive impairment, and learning impairment. So what is visual impairment? The person who cannot clearly see the things, or the user who is visually impaired, who cannot see the things very clearly. Physical impairment means what? The user who have some physical issues or physical problem, like we are using our hand to access the system. Agar kisi ke paas haath hi nahi hai to us haath se wo kaise kya test kar payega. So this is what the type of your physical impairment, where the physical organ or the physical thing of a human being is missing, and this will lead to the that type of accessibility testing. Then next is hearing impairment. Main kisi ko sunai nahi deta, yahan pe bahut bar beep 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 bajte jayega, बट आपको सुनाई नहीं देगा, इसकी वजह से यू विल नॉट एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई व्हाट एग्जैक्टली हैपनिंग एंड हाउ इट इज हैपनिंग. कॉग्निटिव मींस व्हाट? इट इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द ह्यूमन साइकोलॉजी. एंड लर्निंग मींस व्हाट? जल्दी समझ में नहीं आता है, रिपीट करना पड़ता है, काफी टाइम्स रिपीट करना पड़ता है. दैट इज वन टाइप ऑफ योर व्हाट? लर्निंग इम्पेयरमेंट. वेट अ मिनट. सो दीज आर द टाइप्स ऑफ योर व्हाट? इम्पेयरमेंट्स, वेयर the accessibility testing have been done. A good website or a good web application should cater all sets of people and not just limited to disabled people. When we are going to test the web application on, or when we are going to test any of the system, we should not focus on only the disabled people. We should consider all the types of users, all each and every type of user. Means the user with impairment, or the user who do not have any kind of impairment, that is a normal user. That means we can say web application should be, or the any system should be tested for normal as well as abnormal users. Remember this. So disabled people can be users with poor communication infrastructure. The user who have very poor communication infrastructure, we should focus such kind of user. For example, consider right now you are at your home and you do not have proper connectivity, internet connectivity with you. You will be facing the communication problem. So you have some poor communication infrastructure at your end. I am in college and I have very good infrastructure with me. यहाँ पे नेट है, सिस्टम है या लैपटॉप है, मोबाइल है, काफी सारी चीजें मेरे पास अवेलेबल है. बट आप लोग घर पे हो और आपके पास लैपटॉप नहीं है, या आप जहाँ पे रहते हो वहाँ पे प्रॉपर कनेक्टिविटी नहीं आती है, फिर आप कहीं पे जाते हो, बिल्डिंग के ऊपर जाते हो, वहां से नेट कनेक्टिविटी लेके आप लेक्चर प्रैक्टिकल अटेंड करते हैं. सो दिस इज व्हाट द पुअर कम्युनिकेशन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. ओल्डर पीपल एंड न्यू यूजर हु आर ऑफन कंप्यूटर इलिटरेट मीन्स व्हाट. ओल्डर पीपल मीन्स हैविंग जिनका काफी एज हो चुका है, ऐसे ओल्ड पीपल, और द न्यू यूजर जिनको अभी तक सिस्टम या कंप्यूटर या एप्लीकेशन को कैसे हैंडल करना है उसका प्रॉपरली नॉलेज नहीं है. वी शुड फोकस दिस काइंड ऑफ पीपल ऑल्सो. रिमेंबर दिस. देन नेक्स्ट इज यूजर्स यूजिंग ओल्ड सिस्टम दैट इज नॉट कैपेबल ऑफ रनिंग द लेटेस्ट सॉफ्टवेयर. सो वी आर गोइंग टू फोकस सच यूजर्स who have very old system. Means now aaj ka jo zamana hai wo that is for i3 i5 processors, and still many people are using p1 p2 p3 or p4 processors. So we should consider such users who have older systems, and your web application should be tested on such systems. Users who are using non-standard equipment. Non-standard means what? You know what is standard equipment and what is non-standard equipment. Non-standard equipment, we can simply call it as China devices. Users who are having restricted access. Restricted access means what? Nowadays, internet connectivity is of 4G. But aap kahi pe aise jagah pe reh rahe ho jahan pe aapko hardly 2G या 3G मिलता है. So you are having the restricted access of the internet connectivity. और college में अपने पास proxy server है. So on the proxy server you are not able to access your YouTube or Facebook or other social networking sites. So how you are going to test? So this is type of your what? Restricted access. So this is what the accessibility testing is. So we are going to use some software. For example, speech recognition software, it will going to convert spoken word to text which serves as input to the system. Now I am using this kind of software on my system. Agar mujhe mail likhna hai to main kya karta hu, abhi mail ko main pura type nahi karta hu. Maine ek plugin install kar liya hai Google Chrome ke liye. That plugin is going to help me. I am simply talking the mail content and that plugin is going to write whatever text it is going to recognize from my speech. So speech recognition software will be treated as a input to your system. Screen reader software, it is used to read out the text that is displayed on the screen. Screen ke upar jo kuch bhi aapka text hai, that application is going to read your text. That means it is text to speech. Aur previous jo bhi tha, ye first wala jo bhi tha, that is your speech to text. Remember this. Screen magnification software, every system have this screen magnification software. It is used to enlarge the monitor and make reading easy for vision impaired users. Those who have vision impaired problems, for that purpose, for that people or for those users, there is screen magnification software for every operating system. It is by default installed. सिंपली उसे जूम कीजिए, आप लोग क्या कर सकते हो, उसे इजीली देख सकते हो. यू कैन सी हियर, सी दिस, आई हैव, मैंने इसे जूम किया है लाइक दिस. सो दिस इज यूज फॉर विजुअली इम्पेयर्ड यूजर्स, और एस्केप करने के बाद आपका वो जो भी हो रिमूव हो जाएगा. सो दैट इज व्हाट योर स्क्रीन मैग्निफिकेशन सॉफ्टवेयर इज. Special keyboard made for the users for easy typing who have monitor control difficulty. Who have motor control difficulties. So there are some special kind of keyboards, जिनको दिखता नहीं उनके लिए भी कीबोर्ड है. देखिए आप, आपको अगर पता होगा जो लोग ब्रेल यूज करते हैं उनके लिए भी स्पेशल कीबोर्ड है. दे ट्राई टू रिकॉग्नाइज द कीज एंड दे स्टार्ट टाइपिंग यूजिंग योर व्हाट दोज स्पेशल कीबोर्ड. अगर आप लोगों को पता होगा तो आपने ये देखा होगा. तो सो दीज आर सम टाइप ऑफ एप्लीकेशंस दैट एवरी सिस्टम हैव फॉर एक्सेसिबिलिटी टेस्टिंग. नाउ वी विल सी व्हाट इज स्ट्रक्चरल टेस्टिंग वर्सेस स्टैटिक टेस्टिंग. What is static testing? The name itself suggests that this kind of testing is done statically. It is a technique by which we can check the defects in software without actually executing it. That is, this type of testing is done during your compile time, not at the runtime. That is, we are going to test the system before its execution. So this is a type of your testing, or it is a technique by which we can check the defect in the system without actually executing. Execution करने के पहले ही हम लोग उसे identify करते हैं इसमें कौन से type के error हो सकते हैं या इसमें कौन से type के errors हैं. That is your static testing. Then next is its counterpart is dynamic testing, which checks an application when code is in run. So the second type is your dynamic testing, and the name itself suggests that you are very well aware about static and dynamic. So this type of testing is done when your code is in running state. Static testing should be done to avoid errors at early stages of your development. Starting में ही आप लोग क्या करते हो, static testing करते हो, so that आपके अगर कुछ errors है तो वो initial stages में ही avoid हो जाएंगे, आपके minimize हो जाएंगे. For that purpose, your static testing is done on the system. Static testing helps find error that may not be found by dynamic testing. Yes, very true. This kind of testing can be find out which cannot be identified using your dynamic testing. There are two main types of your static testing. Number one, manual examination. The name itself indicating that this type of testing is done manually or by taking the manual examinations. मैनुअल एग्जामिनेशन मीन्स वॉज ओरली कुछ तो भी क्वेश्चन पूछेंगे और आप कोड को देख के बताओगे वेदर इट विल बी राइट और रॉन्ग. दैट इज योर मैनुअल एग्जीक्यूशन. एंड सेकेंड वन इज ऑटोमेटेड एनालिसिस यूजिंग टूल्स. वी आर गोइंग टू यूज सम एडिशनल टूल्स फॉर ऑटोमेटेड एनालिसिस पर्पज. दीज आर द टू टाइप्स ऑफ योर व्हाट स्टैटिक टेस्टिंग. रिमेंबर दिस. वेयर एज the structural testing is the testing, it is also known as your glass box testing or your white box testing. And you know what is glass box or white box testing is. Tests are derived from the knowledge of the software structure or internal implementation. Where it has been focused, structural testing is going to focus on the software's structure or internal implementation. Internal implementation means what? How your system have been implemented. This structural testing is going to focus on how. Kaise implement kiya hai, code kaise likha hai. That is your structural testing. Other names of structural testing includes clear box testing, open box testing, logic driven testing or path driven testing. Exam mein isme se koi bhi word aapko aa sakta hai. You need to identify what exactly that type of testing is, and you should write about your structural testing. That's it.